Hey guys, so today I wanted to walk us through how to dig into your faith when you don't know where to start. So right now we all have a lot of time on our hands because we're in this quarantine and there's just not much to do. So with that being said, it's a great time to dig deeper into your faith, whether you have never really decided what you believe or your relationship with God has been kind of not that great and you want to deepen it. So in this video, I'm going to walk you through a few pointers on how to help you dig into your faith when you don't know where to start. And I'm also going to share a little bit about my own story. So growing up, I wasn't very close to God. I didn't really know much about him. I thought he was very, very distant and that my life, like I just had to kind of worry about my own life and that was up to me. I also really went into people pleasing and tried to seek others' validation so I could feel good about myself. So that was kind of like my God was like people pleasing. And I didn't really, again, know who God was, didn't really know about the Bible. That just wasn't really something that I got into. I also thought that people, like the Christians at my school, were weird and like all that stuff. You know, I was that person. Sophomore year of high school, I got to a point where I just didn't really know who I was and I didn't really know what my purpose was. I didn't know who I was, like who I was created to be. With that, I started thinking about God and like, okay, maybe God knows who I am. Maybe God can give me the purpose that I'm looking for. I remember typing Jesus into Google. I literally Googled Jesus and I got to this really weird website with italic words. And it was just like, I think this really old kind of prayer and I was a little creeped out. So I X'd out of that real quick. And then I just moved on with my life. And a few days later, one of my best friends suggested this book called The Purpose Driven Life by Rick Warren. And she told me it was all about finding your purpose. And so I was elated at the sound of that. I started reading that book and it was all about God. I got so excited about this book and I was just on a Jesus high. And so ever since then, I started to read the Bible and find a mentor and get into community. And it has been such an amazing journey to really know God finally. If that's you right now, where you do not know what you believe and you've been intimidated by this whole God and Jesus thing, like, but you're interested in him and you like want to know more about him, I want to welcome you and say that that is a great place to be, especially right now, because you have the time to really dig in and learn about what you believe. If that's you, I want to walk you through a few pointers on what you can do to dig into your faith right now when you don't know where to start. So the number one thing I would suggest you to do to start out is to just start the conversation. A lot of times the idea of prayer is very like, you have to say certain things or you have to use the words thou and shall, and like that it's just this really complicated thing, when really prayer is very, very simple. It's just talking to God. Talking to God like you would talk to your best friend, like you would talk to your mom, like you would just talk to anyone that you want to get really deep with. That is how a conversation with God should be. So whatever you want to tell your mom that day or your best friend or whatever you want to get off your chest, God is a great person to tell those things and he is listening. He's always with you. He cares about you and it's not a burden to him to hear these things on your heart. The second thing I would recommend you doing is learning. So there are a ton of resources online for how to learn more about God's character. Some I would suggest are sermons. So you can go on YouTube and look up sermons. Some that I've been loving are from Crossroads as well as VU Church and Transformation Church. These are some churches that I would start out with. The second place I would suggest you learning from is the Bible. If this freaks you out, because the Bible totally freaked me out for a very long time. It just kind of stayed on my shelf collecting dust. I thought it was boring. I thought it was written in a different language. Like I literally didn't know if I would understand it, but this book literally will change your life. And I don't even mean to say that in a weird way. I mean to say that in just like in a genuine way. Like it literally will change your life. And it is how God speaks to us. If you're too intimidated by this thing, I would recommend a devotional. A devotional is a book that guides you through reading scripture and reading the Bible. So it's a book that you'd probably read like every morning, like a page or a chapter every morning. Sometimes it's like 20 minutes, sometimes it's 5 minutes. Some devotionals I would suggest are Jesus Calling and the Blue Book. So devotionals are huge, sermons are huge with learning. And additionally, I would suggest some books. You want to read The Purpose-Driven Life by Rick Warren. That is a great book to dive into. Another book I would suggest, if you want, is this book that I wrote in the past year called A Scoop of Honey. It's basically just walking you through how to dig into your faith when you don't know where to start. So the third thing I would suggest you doing is diving into community. So you're probably thinking that right now it is very difficult to get into community because we have to be social distancing, and I totally get that. But there are still ways to meet other people who are pursuing their faith as well. And so what you can do is go on churches' websites and join online Bible studies. I am in one right now through Crossroads. They have a great groups program where you can just sign up for a group and get involved with people. But every week we have a Bible study on our Zoom call, and it is great, and it's still so life-giving even though it's not in person. So I'd recommend joining a Bible study, or if you know someone who is deep in their faith and has been pursuing that, feel free to reach out to them and ask them if you can like be friends. I don't know. Just reach out and tell them that you admire their faith and that you would love to just like talk and talk about Jesus together. I don't know. You never know how a new friendship could bud. So those are just a few tips for me on how to get started with your faith. I hope that these tips were helpful. And if you want to dig even deeper, there is a free ebook waiting for you in my link in bio. And I would love for you to check out this free ebook. I hope that you guys enjoyed this video. Comment below some tips that you have on strengthening your faith in this season, and we can all help each other out. So I hope you guys enjoyed this video and have a great day.